Just I know in Japan, you have a disaster prevention minister. The, you prepare to have a ministry of disaster prevention. Just I know. I saw the news and just like follow the US, they have a FEMA. In Taiwan, we also have some voice, a lot of people, because right now the fire department in charge of the disaster. So I'm wondering what's the situation in Japan right now for the central government?
Although the minister exists, that's, you know, more of a political consideration rather than the actual sort of administration of disaster management, because the disaster management is shared by many different ministries. Ministry of former Ministry of Construction. Well, it has a long name, but anyway, I will call it Ministry of Construction. Ministry of Construction basically has authority over rivers and dams, sea coast, and so forth, in providing infrastructure and providing the construction of dams, riverbanks, and so forth. But the welfare of people is the realm that the Ministry of Welfare and Labor takes care of. So there is already a split. And then the Self-Defense Forces is controlled completely by a different law and by a different minister. And you'll have to, you know, in order to ask the Self-Defense Forces to be activated, then, you know, you'll have to go through different channels and it'll have to be asked. But if there were the Ministry of Disaster Management, under which the Self-Defense Forces, or, you know, larger part of the function comes under that wing, then the minister can make a decision and send the Self-Defense Forces immediately to the affected places and you know, start helping the fire departments. And so that kind of streamlining the complicated system is a necessity. This is also what I mentioned in my speech, that self-defense forces are there for possibly protecting people from war. But we haven't had any victims of war for 75 years. But we have victims from natural disasters every year. And as the climate emergency increases, I think the number will go up. So we'll have to address that problem by concentrating all these complicated and diversified sort of branches of government into one, to take a quick action and also to make preparations beforehand with money to protect people from disasters. Also, fire departments are not unified either. They are loosely connected, but they're independently owned by prefectures and cities. And the coordination of different fire departments also is a big problem.
Okay, thank you. And Japan and Taiwan, we are all in the earthquake zone. And however, just I know, when I was in Japan before, and I saw you have lots of the early warning system, we call EEW. Taiwan right now, we also have EEW. But our government use such this kind of information pushed to the people's mobile phone directly. Mm-hmm. So sometimes the people will watch, oh, earthquake, and then wait. So watch the earthquake will come or not. And if the earthquake is not so strong, they will complain. Oh, it's a prediction wrong. And actually, nobody do anything about the earthquake come. Just I know in Japan, you have a very good education. Even the warning, EEW warning, is not to people, it's to machine. For example, elevators and also some lots of the construction work. So I'm wondering how to strengthen the consensus of the people about their disaster prevention consensus. How can we strengthen their idea about that? Because Japan is a good model of Taiwan.
Well, thank you for saying that, but in my own experience, I learned that earthquakes are something that we have to sort of respond to or react to immediately by the parents' education. As I mentioned, both of my parents had the experience of the great Kanto earthquake in 1923. And so everybody of my generation learned from their parents within the family to extinguish fire first and so forth. So that's education within the family is very important. And also we had the evacuation drills in schools, and that also, you know, helped. I remember vividly that, you know, just in the United States in the 1950s and 60s, they had the evacuation drill when the nuclear weapons just happened to hit, but they do not have any drills for earthquakes because there are practically none. But I think earthquake drills or flood drills or disaster drills are very, very important for children to at least learn and be prepared. But all in all, I'm not very happy to say this, but all in all, we had to learn it through our experiences. Now, despite all these experiences, for example, Hanshin Awaji in 1995, there was a massive damage. And of course, it's because the earthquake hit early in the morning, 5 a.m. And so people are still sleeping, but they could not really react to the earthquake quick enough. But still, we learned a great deal from that. And also, we learned even more from the Great East Japan earthquake. Our consciousness is very high at this point, I believe. But one way to send the message is through the videos, I believe, because that the people's consciousness this time was heightened because they saw the tsunami hitting towns and areas that they had never imagined, really. But history actually shows that those residents in those areas should have been prepared in some way, because in the 19th century, the same thing actually did happen, but the memory was lost, over more than 100 years. But we do have the memory of watching television and seeing trucks and cars are being washed away and houses are being lost in TV programs. And there are realistic videos predicting future mega earthquakes that would happen, I guess, within 30 years. And the probability is 70 to 80%, and so forth. And I think, watching this video directly with your city being part of the affected area, I think that's very important. Just when you see a building that you're familiar with or restaurants that you go to is affected by the tsunami or the earthquake, and that would send the direct message. So it's very important to tie your daily lives to the possibility of the future earthquakes and other disasters as well.
Thank you. And my last question is about the cooperations. And my role is a Taiwan Disaster Industry Associations. And just I know lots of the Japan, because you have lots of disaster, you have very, very innovations disaster industry. For example, the disaster food, and the food is not traditional food, but we can save it maybe probably to 3 to 5 years. And when the disaster happened, such is kind of food and can help us maybe much more convenient for our daily life, because sometimes when a disaster happens, you cannot easy to have enough and all food for ourselves. So such is kind of a industry. We found lots of the industry, just like in Japan, you have lots of the innovation about a disaster. However, in Taiwan, it's not easy. Lots of the disaster are government. Everybody think it's a government job. It's not our job. So it's not easy to have a disaster industry in Taiwan. So I'm wondering, how can we, Taiwan and Japan, cooperate in the future, especially for the regional or international?
Yeah, that's a very, very good question, and I think important relationship that we'll have to establish. And the first thing I would like to propose is that the weather forecasts in both countries sort of at least briefly show what's going on in other countries in the same region. In the weather forecast, the typical report we hear about neighbor is that, okay, typhoon was coming toward Japan, but alas, we are spared because it's heading toward Korea, and then we kind of, we are relieved. But in addition to that, we should also hear the information that that typhoon that missed Japan would do to Korea. Or, if a typhoon is going toward Taiwan, and therefore we are, spared from that typhoon. But then a little bit more about what that typhoon is doing to Taiwanese people. Then our awareness of, having to share the same sort of destiny would heighten our awareness of connecting with each other. As you mentioned that, we do have good packages chips that had been prepared for us, you know, simply to buy. If we go to a supermarket, we can buy a kit, and that includes food, and sometimes that includes the portable toilet that, you know, we can use for a few days and so forth. And, you know, that, you know, can be an item that we can, you know, export. More, the idea of such a thing should be exported to Taiwan. But in the beginning, probably the actual kit that might be very good. Then once you experience that it is important to have such a kit, then logical conclusion is that many people would start seeing that as not only a possibility, but as a reality that will have to come, you know, into their daily lives.
Good. Let's work together. So my final question will be, I'm wondering, do you have any comments about our Mayor Chen? And because Mayor Chen is a very popular politician in Taiwan, and the Taoyuan is a very important city in Taiwan. And you are the former mayor of Hiroshima, also very, very successful mayor in Japan. So do you have any comment about Mayor Chen and give him some advice? Because our Earth Day Summit, he talked a lot about the Taoyuan, what Taoyuan did. Do you have any suggestion or comments or advice to Mayor Chen?
Yes, when I listened to Mayor Chen's comment and report on his activities, I thought he was doing a wonderful job, and you know, envied him for having the you know, foresight about natural disasters, and also, you know, have sort of created the ability to manage the situation when a disaster hits. And that's a very good quality for a mayor and for a good politician or statesman. And I thought that he was one very, very fine example of such a statement that we can all emulate.
And I hope the pandemic will go away and you can come to Taiwan and we can have a real conversation in the near future.
Yeah, I look forward to that day. And thank you very much for initiating this summit. International cooperation is very important, and through this I've been able to learn a great deal, and also that heightened my consciousness and appreciation for what we have done successfully, and also that I have a keener eye now to analyzing the things that we'll have to change for the future.